What's up, guys? It's Future here. In this video, we got the shower scene by Ice9 Kills. I'm excited for this one. I don't really know why. Just the shower scene. That's such an iconic movie scene, you know? Like, a lot of horror and thrillers have that, you know? You have a girl taking a shower that they might show some skin here and there, and the killer be watching her through the, you know, the steamy glass, or, like, he'll write something on the steamy mirror or something creepy. And it's just like so many horror and thrillers have had that, so it's really iconic to have that, and I'm excited to see where Ink goes with this. I don't know if this is gonna be based off a horror movie. The last two have it. I mean, let me know, guys, down in the comment below. A Rash Decision, was that based off a movie? I didn't like hear any references like towards a movie or something. It just sounded like a horror-esque song, and like Welcome to Horrorwood, that was just like the introduction to the album. So I'm hoping that they kind of stay to their roots and, like, still base some songs off of some movies, you know? Because, like, Hip to Be Scared, American Psycho, you got Assault and Batteries, that's Child's Play, and then Funeral Derangement, that's Pet Cemetery, you know? So, like, we got a couple, but I'm hoping we still get some more, you know? I'm hoping those weren't the only ones. Let's see what they give us.
Come on in, the weather's dreadful, we always have a room to spare.
Okay, this is based off something. What is it based off, though? Oh, man. What's this based off of? I love horror movies. I've seen a lot. But there's also a lot I haven't seen. So, what is this based off, guys? We gotta find out.
It's not well. Doctors say she's not all there. She's crazy, I must confess.
Man.
I'm so sick of cleaning up her mess.
He sounds good in this album. Like, Spencer's always been, like, really good. But, I don't know, I feel like the production's so much better on this album. Like, the effects on his voice and just the way he sounds, he sounds awesome.
In up a mess. I hope say
that was epic. Like, Spencer sang his heart out there. That was awesome. You got a good fade out scream transition back into the second verse. I'm liking these verses. Like, it's nice to have some diversity in this album, because, like, so far, like, pretty much every song, like, every verse has kind of sounded the same, just kind of like really energetic, fast-paced screams throughout the whole verses, and then, like, Spencer comes in with a melodic, heavy, like, beautiful chorus. But it's nice that they're, like, in this song, they're dropping it down a little bit and, like, just letting it flow.
Come on back, I'll fix you something, but careful not to cross the line. 'Cause she and I are sure of one thing.
I don't know what it's all about.
She's crazy.
That is one of my favorite breakdowns of 2021. No, like, holy shit. Man, I love when they add, like, horror movie sound effects into their songs. Like, that little, like, ding, ding. Like, that is such a horror movie thing. Like, that always happens, like, when, like, the killer or, like, whatever's happening in the movie is, like, looking at, like, their victim, like, through a window or something. And then they'll, like, show a shot of the killer, like, standing behind something or something. And you'll hear, like, the ding, ding. Like, that, oh, man. I'm sorry. I want to hear that again. Like, I just want to hear that again, so.
Several days now. I've reason to believe she may have stopped off at this very motel.
Okay, so this is obviously based off a movie. Comment down below what this is based off of. I don't know. Either I haven't seen it or I'm stupid. That was the shower scene from the new Silver Scream 2 album. Oh my god. That, like, this album is fucking awesome. It is just so awesome. I can't even. I loved the vibe from this one. Like, it was just. It was more melodic and, like, slower than the other one so far. It, you know, Spencer really got to show his melodic and, like, the singing capabilities in this one a lot more than he usually can. Because they do a lot of screaming. And even the screams in this one were cool. They had a lot of, like, background, like, fade-out screams that were really cool. Like, even in that outro, like, that scream just, like, slowly faded out. And then they had, like, a movie snippet, I assume, on this. I mean, please comment what this movie is, like, what the song is about. Like, what is this movie? I guess I haven't seen it. I mean, I haven't seen every horror movie, so it makes sense. But yeah, that was awesome. Let me know what you guys thought about the song. Breakdown was awesome. Chorus was awesome. Verses were awesome. Just an awesome song overall. Let me know what you guys thought about it. What's your guys' favorite song so far? Like, I honestly can't even just, like, Hip to Be Scared and Funeral Derangements are two really good songs. But I think the only reason I'm saying those are my two favorite is because I've had time for them to really grow on me because they've been out for a little bit. Especially Hip to Be Scared. That was the first song that came out for the album. Yeah, let me know what songs you guys like so far. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this reaction, drop a like. There will be a playlist linked in the description for all my Ice Nine Kills reactions if you guys want to check those out as well. Also, my gaming channel, Discord server, Instagram, and Twitter are all linked in the description if you guys want to join those. Thank you guys for watching. We're going to get into this next song. Subscribe and turn post notifications on if you guys want to see the rest of my Ice Nine Kills reactions. They'll be coming up over, you know, the next day or two. So, yeah, you guys don't want to miss those. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the future.